investment pieces. Let's talk investment pieces today, ladies. I'm super excited about today's video. I've put a lot of thought and effort into picking five amazing items that I honestly couldn't live without, and I truly believe that they are worth the investment. But stick around, make sure you listen to this entire video because there is a bonus item at the end of the video that I've actually worn throughout the video with multiple looks, and I think it's also an amazing item. But before I get started, I just wanted to thank each and every one of you for listening to my videos, for watching my videos, for your support, for your encouragement, for shopping off of my links. Like, I'm truly grateful for each and every one of you. I wouldn't be able to do what I love doing if it weren't for you guys. So from the bottom of my heart, thank you so much. I did start my channel roughly 2 years ago to help women just like you, to help you guys look and feel amazing and honestly like the best versions of yourselves, because I believe no matter what your age, you deserve to look and feel confident. So if that sounds good to you, if you would hit that little subscribe button, I would truly appreciate it. Okay, let's tackle this subject. Five investment pieces every woman should own. The number one piece is a classic black blazer. And I've got several options for you guys at several different price points. Also know this, every investment piece that I'm talking about, I will also be linking a dupe version down below in my description box, because I believe no matter what your budget, you should be able to shop on my channel. And as always, everything that I am talking about and showing you in all of these incredibly chic looks will be linked down below in my description box. So the first blazer I want to talk about is the Balmain blazer. You have seen it on my channel before. I've owned the black Balmain blazer now for probably roughly 3 years. It is still as timeless and as special to me today as it was 3 years ago the day I bought it. A classic black blazer will never go out of style, so it's important that you have a good one in your closet that you love wearing, that fits you well, that you feel just confident when you put it on, because a black blazer is a power jacket. You can wear it to the office. You can wear it on a date. You can wear it on a girl's night out. You can wear it with your yoga pants or your biker shorts on the weekends with sneakers. Like, that's a hot trend that we're seeing in 2021, is like the blazer with like the biker shorts or the leggings. So I'm kind of like slowly becoming a fan of the biker short. I might do a video styling those 10 different ways, because that's honestly a trend that I thought I would never wear, and I just bought my first pair 2 days ago. So let me know in the comments below, are you a fan of the biker shorts or not? But honestly, a black blazer, again, you definitely need a good one in your closet. So the Balmain blazer, the fit is impeccable. It is like the mother of all blazers. When you put one on, you will know what I'm talking about. It hugs your curves in all the right places. It's cut in exactly where a well-structured blazer should be cut in. The material is very high quality. It's wrinkle-free. There are beautiful luxe gold buttons on this blazer. And this is just honestly one of my absolute favorite jackets hanging in my closet. It does have shoulder pads, and I do have pretty broad shoulders, squared, you know, they're very squared off, and I can get away with wearing the Balmain blazer even though it does have shoulder pads. So I will say, if you're a woman with broad shoulders like me, you should be okay with the Balmain blazer. Now, it is obviously an investment. It'll run you around $2,000 or so, but you can get one on the RealReal, which I will link down below, or Tradesy, one of those amazing consignment stores. You can get one gently used and, you know, get a significant discount. So that's a way around it. You could also save up your money. Obviously, everyone knows that, but this is something that I've been doing for years. Instead of buying a bunch of, you know, cheap items or things that won't last, I kind of make a list at the beginning of every month, sometimes every quarter, like, okay, this quarter or this month or whatever it is for you, you know, this is the item that I'm going to be looking for. This is the item I'm going to be saving up for, and I'm not going to buy all those other small items. So you make a list, and it will take maybe a couple of years to build a wardrobe that you want, a really amazing wardrobe made up of investment pieces. So be patient with yourself. Also reward yourself. Maybe you set goals for yourself and you say, you know, when I reach this goal, I'm going to reward myself with that amazing, you know, Chanel handbag or that amazing Veronica Beard beard blazer or whatever that is for you. Like, I think that's a good thing to do. Be patient with yourself, set goals, and make a list of what investment pieces you want to add to your wardrobe so that you will eventually have that amazing wardrobe that you want because you absolutely deserve it. So I styled this Babylon blazer with denim. I just wanted to keep it very simple. I did a black bodysuit. A V-neck black bodysuit is another piece I couldn't live without in my closet. This one's by Allison Olivia and it's old, but I'll be linking a similar one by Spanx that's just as amazing, and it's actually part of the Nordstrom Anniversary sale and under $50. These are the A-Gold E90s pinch waist jeans. This is definitely the it silhouette for 2021 in terms of denim, sort of that high-waisted straight leg jean, and I will say I'm a big fan. Now, if you are not a fan of ripped jeans, I totally get it. This exact denim silhouette comes in a version with absolutely no rips in them, so I will be linking them down below as well. Then I went with a Valentino gold chain belt because I honestly think adding a belt to any look is always going to take it to the next level. And then I did these awesome Cult Gaia gold chain black mules that I just picked up from Neiman Marcus. I love these heels. They will definitely be on high rotation for me this fall and winter. Now, the best dupe to the Balmain black blazer would have to be this blazer by Lily Silk. As you can see, it almost looks identical. Obviously, the differences are the silhouette is a little bit different, although the Lily Silk is still a very classic and timeless structured blazer. The material is high quality, although it's not as heavy duty as the Balmain blazer. It still has the beautiful gold luxe buttons. I will say the fit is very flattering and very slimming, so if you didn't want to spend the money on the Balmain blazer, I would highly recommend the Lily Silk blazer. It's very high quality. It is guaranteed to take you many places in style this fall and winter, and honestly all year round. Okay, the next blazer would be the white Balmain blazer. So just like the black Balmain blazer, the white one is a beautiful, timeless, and classic blazer. I think a white blazer can go a long way in any woman's wardrobe, almost as far as a black blazer. Again, the fit is impeccable. It's cut in at just the right places. It has the beautiful gold buttons. It also has the shoulder pads. I did pick this one up about 2 years ago when I was on a trip with my husband. It was actually on sale, so I got really lucky. But this is a jacket I have treasured. I still wear it quite often, even though it is a few years old, proving that a blazer is timeless, it's versatile, and it will never go out of style, which is why it's important that you own an amazing black blazer as well as a white blazer, because you will honestly be able to wear both so many different ways in so many places. So what I did with this blazer, again, paired it with denim. These are the Mother jeans. They are called the Rider. They're also a high-waisted straight leg jean. These are actually available on the Revolve website. They've been sold out for a while, but they're now restocked. Yay, like these jeans are amazing. They're also very soft and very comfortable, so highly recommend them. Okay, the next blazer I recommend that's a step down from the Balmain blazer, but it is still a very, very high quality, amazing blazer, and that is the Veronica Beard Scuba Blazer. Now, I love this blazer because it doesn't have any hardware on it, so I think it makes it that much more versatile and just that much more, you know, just can kind of go either way, dressy or casual, wear it with sneakers, wear it with heels, wear it with sandals. Like, literally, the possibilities are endless because this blazer is so versatile. I want to say a couple other things about the Veronica Beard blazer. Again, the cut is amazing. It's very slimming. It is a structured blazer. I really love the scuba material because it doesn't wrinkle. It's not like too heavy, so you can honestly wear this blazer in the warmer months as well. This blazer does come in white and it does come in navy, which I think are two very basic, great colors that could add a lot to your wardrobe. Another cool thing about Veronica Beard blazers and why I love them so much is because you can zip in and out Dickies into these blazers, making them look like an entirely different blazer. So they have cashmere Dickies, they have leopard Dickies, they have leather Dickies, they have plaid Dickies, they have all sorts of camo, like all sorts of Dickies. So I will link a couple of my favorites down below because I think that's really what makes the Veronica Beard blazer that unique and that wearable and also very versatile, because again, it will look like an entirely different blazer when when you switch in and out the Dickies, but you certainly don't have to wear the Dickies. A lot of times I wear my Veronica Beard blazer just plain without the Dickie. But what I paired it with is this amazing midi dress. This is a beautiful camel midi dress by Anza Costa. I love the fit. I love the really cool neckline. It's got these neat little straps that kind of go over your neck, really exposing your shoulder, so very tastefully sexy. I love this camel color. I think you can't go wrong with a neutral camel shade. Anything that's neutral and anything that's camel is going to look like an investment piece. It's going to look like, you know, more expensive than it really is. So always keep that tip in mind. And then I did a really amazing and fun leopard YSL crossbody bag that I got a month or two ago from Neiman Marcus, and I've been carrying it a ton. And then I did the same Cult Gaia gold chain heels because I'm in love with them. They're so comfortable because they're open toe and the heel height is only 3 inches. Okay, the next investment piece I think every woman should own is a leather jacket, the infamous leather jacket. And if I'm being honest, I'm more of a leather jacket girl than I am a blazer girl. Like, how about you? Do you love wearing leather jackets more or do you love wearing blazers more? Leave me a comment down below and let me know because I always love hearing from you guys. The first leather jacket I want to talk about is this amazing Eero leather jacket. It is phenomenal. Like, the leather is better. Soft. I would say Eero makes probably the absolute best leather jacket on the market. Again, the leather is supple. It is so soft. It just like hugs your curves in all the right places. It molds to your body. It only gets more comfortable the more you wear it. So like I said, I've had it for like 5 years and it is probably one of the most comfortable jackets I own. You know, you can wear it with a slip dress. You can wear it with denim. You can wear it with, you know, a midi skirt. Like, literally the possibilities are endless because a leather jacket is so versatile, so timeless, and just very, very wearable. It does have a little bit of edge to it. So if you have an edgy style like I do, then I bet you love leather jackets as much as I do. I think maybe I have a vice with leather jackets. Like, that's probably one of my, you know, small addictions there. I think I own too many, but in my defense, I do wear them a ton. I love this silver hardware. I think this one is beautiful. It's just a great jacket. And obviously, since I've had it for so long and I still wear it very often, I know it was a great investment, especially when I consider the cost per wear. What I paired it with are these beautiful ivory jeans. These are actually by Silver Lake and they're called the Beatnik. So these are more of a modern skinny jean versus like the straight leg denim that I've had on earlier in this video. So very high waisted. Again, instead of being like that super tight sort of jegging skinny jean, these are just more of like a slim fit, but they still are tapered at the ankle. I love this ivory shade, and I was really wanting to do a look of like a black top, the ivory bottoms, and then with that leopard handbag, I thought that just really tied everything in beautifully, and I really just love this look. Now, the Eero leather jacket is going to run you around $1,200. It does come in navy as well. It actually comes in multiple colors, so I will be linking those down below in the description box. Now, another leather jacket that is still a real leather jacket, but it's going to run you around, I think, $500 or so, so still a great deal, is the Lamarque leather jacket. I think this one is called, it starts with a D, it's called the Dylan leather jacket. I have it in several colors because it's that good. It's a very fashion forward leather jacket fit. The reason is the sleeves are bigger. It's got almost like a dolman sleeve to it. So it's a bit like oversized, but it's still a little on the shorter side. So I think it's still very flattering. Definitely the jacket trend in 2021 is heading more towards like the oversized jacket. So I absolutely love this leather jacket. It does have shoulder pads. It's very 80s inspired. Again, very fashion forward. And it does come in multiple colors. And for the price, like I said, around $500, give or take, it's really a great deal for a really high quality real leather jacket. And what I paired it with is this beautiful green top that I'm wearing right now. This is by Cult Gaia. I love this sexy cutout sort of, you know, asymmetrical neckline. It also has a cutout right here, so I think it's just kind of a cool top. I really loved this beautiful green color. I think it looks amazing alone, but then you could also top it with that leather jacket and just have an incredibly chic fall look as well. And then I did the same A gold E jeans, my go-to Valentino gold chain belt, And then those Cult Gaia heels that I've had on almost the entire video because they're that wearable and that versatile. Now that same Lamarck leather jacket does come in ivory as well, as you can see here. So I love this ivory shade too. It also comes in white. It actually comes in brown. It comes in like, I don't know, 6 or 7 different colors, but I really loved the ivory shade. Again, you can see like the really cool sort of oversized fit, but then it is still a bit on the cropped side. I paired it over this amazing Anine Bing tank. It's like a mock turtleneck, but it has a really cool sort of sexy cutout. And then the same A Gold E jeans with they're called the 90s pinch waist that I've been wearing. So very high waisted, even though they're a baggier silhouette, the reason they're still so slimming is because they are high waisted. And I love this medium wash specifically for fall and winter, but you can honestly wear these jeans all year round. And then let's talk about these really cool gold spiked heels. These are by Alexander McQueen. I love these. These are definitely an investment too, and I would say an investing in a pair of amazing heels is something you can always, you know, count on. Investing in a handbag, investing in a pair of shoes is always a good idea. Obviously, outerwear is key as well, which is what I've been covering. But these heels are beautiful. They're very edgy because of the gold spikes, and I love wearing them with denim, but then you can also wear them with midi dresses and skirts as well. Okay, the next piece I think every woman should invest in is a white button-down. A classic white button-down can be worn so many different ways. Wear it with denim, wear it with shorts, wear it with skirts, wear it tied over a dress. Like, literally the possibilities are endless, because a white button-down is just a classic staple I think every woman needs. Now, my favorite white button-down hanging in my closet is this one by Nili Lowton. It is an oversized white button-down, which makes it very fashion-forward and just a great staple. I honestly wear it a ton, especially in the spring and summertime. What I paired it with are these black A Gold E shorts. I wanted to show y'all just like a simple summer look, very casual. These are my favorite jean shorts. I have them in black. I also have them in blue. The reason is they're high-waisted, plus the inseam is a little bit longer, so it makes them very sort of age-appropriate since they are a little bit longer. And again, I love the faded black wash because it's very edgy, and that just matches my style perfectly. Then I did these flats. These are just like an easy flat slide. These are from Express, so they're under like $50, I think. So what a great deal. So I just love this easy and effortless summer look. Okay, another way to style this amazing Nili Lowton white button-down is with a simple nude Skims bodysuit. So if you guys tried the Skims bodysuits yet, if you haven't, I highly recommend them. They are literally the most comfortable bodysuits I have ever put on my body. And I'm a big fan of bodysuits. Why? Well, because they stay tucked in. They hold everything in. You don't have to worry about them bunching up or anything like that. So I thought this was just a really kind of cool way to wear a button-down. Sort of like a shirt jacket, so you just leave it unbuttoned, again pairing it over the bodysuit. And then these are some loose fit 90s ripped jeans. Again, if these are too ripped for you, totally get it. I will link the 90s A Gold E jeans that are the same silhouette but that have no rips in them. Then I did a classic nude pump. These are by Christian Louis Vuitton. Another thing that I think you should invest in is a pair of nude pumps and a pair of black pumps. I will say this though, I call these like my going to dinner shoes, because honestly, a closed toe pump, even though I think it's the most beautiful shoe, I think it's the most flattering shoe. It's going to make your legs look longer because of the pointy toe and the nude color really sort of just blending in with your skin tone. But I will say they're the most uncomfortable type of shoes because they are closed toe and they sort of pinch my toes together. So if you agree with me, let me know. That's why you'll see me, yes, wearing heels most of the time, but typically I'll choose like an open toe shoe. Okay, item number 4 that I think every woman needs is an amazing little black dress, specifically a slip dress. So I'm a big fan of this slip dress because it is timeless. It is versatile. You can wear it to the office with a blazer. You can wear it out to dinner on a date night, plain by itself, or be edgy and top it with a leather jacket. Any of the jackets from this edit would look amazing over this Nili Lowton black slip dress. I've had this slip dress for a few years now. I've worn it a ton. Like, it's just always good to have on hand a little black dress that fits you perfectly, that hugs your curves in all the right places, that you really feel amazing in. And that is this dress for me, because it just lays beautifully over my silhouette. It is just a really, you know, luxe silk fabric. It's wrinkle free. And again, you just can't go wrong with a little black dress. So highly recommend the Slip Dress by Nili Lowden. One way to wear it is to top it with the Baumon blazer, the leopard crossbody bag, and then those Cult Gaia gold chain mules. So this would be a really beautiful look, again, to wear on a date night, wear on a girls' night out. Also, maybe you wear to an event, you have a fancy party or something like that. So really, really love the Nili Lowden black slip dress. Another way to wear the slip dress is to top it with a white leather jacket. So this one is a beautiful white leather jacket, also by Lamarck, so sort of that mid-range leather jacket running you around $500 or so. I really love the gold hardware on this leather jacket. That's really what makes it so unique. So this gold hardware is just so beautiful. Again, I don't think you can go wrong with a black leather jacket, but you also can't go wrong with a white leather jacket. So love the contrast of pairing the white leather jacket over the black slip dress. And then I added the leopard handbag to kind of add a bit of interest to this very, very chic and classic and polished look. Okay, another way to wear the slip dress is super casual with the Nili Lowden white button down tied at the waist and then just some simple gold slides. So this is an easy look, very casual. I wanted to show you guys that you can dress down the slip dress, wear it with some flat sandals or even wear it with some sneakers. It would be super cool that way as well. Okay, the next item that I think every woman should invest in is a high quality handbag. So again, maybe this is one of those items that you put on your list and you say, I'm going to save up for a high quality handbag. Now, it doesn't have to be a designer handbag, but it can be. It's totally up to you. There are ways around getting designer handbags for less. One of my favorite ways is on the Real Real or Tradesy, you know, getting a gently used handbag. I would recommend a brand that you know, maybe Chanel, you know, Celine, YSL. I've sold many bags on these sites. I've even bought a Chanel bag. I think it was off of the Real Real, if I'm not mistaken, and I was very pleased with it, very happy with it. So for me, I love Chanel bags. I think they're classic. I think they'll, you know, they hold their resale value as well. So my recommendation to you, if you do decide to get a designer bag, is to definitely save the dust bag, save your receipt, save the box, so that later on down the road, if you get sick of it, not saying you will, but you might, then you can always resell it on one of those sites and then get a different bag that you want. So that's kind of another way around. Like, listen, if you're going to buy a designer bag, then definitely save all the things that go with it so that you can resell it later on for a different designer bag that you want. But you don't have to spend the money on a designer bag. You could certainly go with a high quality handbag such as a Rebecca Minkoff bag that's going to be, you know, a couple hundred dollars, which is, yes, still expensive, but it's still very high quality. It's real leather. It has amazing hardware. Another recommendation I would make is make it a neutral color, whether that be beige or black. Those are the two colors I would recommend because I feel like you can wear them with so many different things. And honestly, a handbag, it should be high quality, but it should also be something that matches everything in your wardrobe so that you can carry it every day. And that's why it needs to be a high quality piece. I don't care if you have on a t-shirt and a pair of ripped jeans and a pair of sneakers. If you're carrying a really cool, amazing, high quality handbag, again, it doesn't have to be Chanel. It can be Rebecca Minkoff, but your outfit is just going to be elevated because you do have that high quality handbag. So I would say invest in a handbag, again, neutral or black. And my personal favorite are Chanel bags. I collect them. I'm hoping to pass them down to my daughters and my granddaughters one day. So I'm very proud of my Chanel bag collection. Anytime I reach a goal, I've actually set a goal to reach 50,000 subscribers on YouTube, and hopefully I'll reach that goal in a month or two. And I think I might reward myself with a Chanel handbag. So thanks to you guys for that, again, for your support. I truly, truly appreciate it. But I recommend doing that as well, like set a goal for yourself, you know, and then reward yourself with something amazing, maybe one of these awesome investment pieces on this list, because like I said before, you absolutely deserve it. Okay, the bonus investment piece, the one we've all been waiting for, is a belt. So whether that's a designer belt, like I said, like I love this Valentino belt I got maybe like 3 or 4 months ago. I've literally worn it all the time. I wear it with every look almost, honestly, because it is a gold chain belt, so it goes with everything. It elevates every look. It's just going to take every look to the next level. But again, it doesn't have to be a designer belt. But I will say, like, I do love the Valentino belts, maybe like the black and brown reversible one, I think would be a great addition to your wardrobe because it is reversible, so you could wear it with the black or with brown. So I love that. You know, you could go with a Gucci belt. I don't think I would do the GG Gucci belt anymore. I think that's seen its days, seen its time, and I feel like it's kind of on its way out. So I wouldn't go for the Gucci belt, but I would say, like I said, a Valentino belt, but it honestly doesn't have to be a designer belt. It can just be a high quality real leather belt. One of my favorite brands of real leather belts that aren't designer, but they're still very high quality and still very chic, or they're called the Clinch belts. I actually have the off-white with the gold buckle. I wear it a ton and I love it as well. I would say maybe get that one in the black or the beige or even the ivory. Again, very neutral colors that will go with so many different things. So I hope this video helped you guys. Those were the 5 investment pieces I think every woman should own. Please let me know what your favorite investment piece was, because I always love hearing from you guys. For more style information, you can head over to SoHeather.com and on Instagram, on SoHeatherBlog. I hope you guys have a beautiful day. And until next time, I will see you soon. Bye-bye.